Hello, and welcome to the return of Folger ENCORES. I'm Cody Nickell, and I'm thrilled that you have chosen to join us today. Now, the Folger has been sharing with you some of their selections of plays and music and readings and talks in this ENCORES series. And this week, we are celebrating the return to school by taking a look at the Folger Theatre production of Arcadia by Tom Stoppard. Now, in this production, I played Septimus Hodge, the tutor to Thomasina, the young woman of the house. Thomasina is a precocious child with many complex ideas about mathematics, nature, and physics, a young woman well ahead of her time. The play is simultaneously set in 1809 and in the present. And as the drawing room comedy of 1809 unfolds in the present, two writers converge on the house, one of whom is researching a hermit that once lived on the grounds, and the other is investigating a mysterious chapter from the life of Lord Byron, a classmate of yours truly. Well, of Septimus Hodge's. What you're about to see is the opening of the play, set in April of 1809 in the front garden room of an English estate, where I am trying to distract Thomasina from her curiosity about carnal embrace by challenging her to prove Fermat's last theorem. Arcadia is one of my favorite shows that I have ever been a part of at the Folger, a truly special production, which hopefully you're about to see in this small selection that we are happy to share with you. Please enjoy this taste of Arcadia. And do remember to join us again for these bi-weekly episodes of ENCORES, highlighting everything that the Folger Shakespeare Library has to offer.
Carnal embrace is the practice of throwing one's arms around the side of beef.
Is that all?
No. A shoulder of mutton, a haunch of venison, well hugged, an embrace of grouse. Caro, carnis, feminine flesh.
Is it a sin?
Not necessarily, my lady. But when carnal embrace is sinful, it is a sin of the flesh, QED. We had Caro in our Gallic Wars. The Britons live on milk and meat. Latte et carne we want. I am sorry that the seed fell on stony ground.
That was the sin of Onan, wasn't it, Septimus?
Yes. He was giving his brother's wife a Latin lesson, and she was hardly the wiser after it than before. I thought you were finding a proof for Fermat's last theorem.
It is very difficult, Septimus. You will have to show me how.
If I knew how, there would be no need to ask you. Fermat's last theorem has kept people busy for 150 years, and I hoped it would keep you busy long enough for me to read Mr. Chater's poem in praise of love with only the distraction of its own absurdities.
Our Mr. Chater has written a poem.
He believes he has written a poem, yes. I can see that there might be more carnality in your algebra than in Mr. Chater's couch of Eros.
It's not my algebra. I heard Jellyby telling Cook that Mrs. Chater was discovered in carnal embrace in the gazebo.
Really? With whom did Jellyby happen to say?
What do you mean? With whom?
With what? Exactly so! The idea is absurd! Where did this story come from?
Mr. Noakes!
Mr. Noakes?
Papa's landscape gardener. He was in the garden taking bearings when he saw, through his spyglass, Mrs. Chater in the gazebo in carnal embrace.
And you mean to tell me Mr. Noakes told the butler?
No! Mr. Noakes told Mr. Chater. Jellyby was told by the groom who overheard Mr. Noakes telling Mr. Chater
Mr. Chater being engaged in closing the stable door.
What do you mean, Septimus?
So, thus far, the only people who know about this are Mr. Noakes, the landscape architect, the groom, the butler, the cook, and, of course, Mrs. Chater's husband, the poet.
And Arthur, who's cleaning the silver, and the boot boy. And now you.
Of course. What else did he say?
Mr. Noakes.
No, not Mr. Noakes. Jellyby. You heard Jellyby telling the cook.
The cook hushed him almost as soon as he started. Jellyby did not see that I was being allowed to finish yesterday's upstairs rabbit pie before I came to my lesson. I do not think you have been candid with me, Septimus. The gazebo is not, after all, a meat larder.
I never said my definition was complete.
It can embrace kissing.
Yes.
And throwing one's arms around Mrs. Tater.
Yes. Now, for that's last
thing. I hope you are ashamed.
I, my lady.
If you do not teach me the true meanings of things, who will?
Ah.